Front of the house for picture taking.
When they all go out there.
Yeah, after we get dressed,
okay, that's good.
Okay. Now, practice going out, and now women, you can step right into your dressing room.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
try to walk away. I got my heart set on our wedding day. I got a vision of a girl in a white. Made my decision that you all right. When I take your hand, I'll watch my heart set sail. Take my trembling. Like a true companion, I got a true companion. You are my true companion. Oh, a true companion. When the years have done irreparable harm, we'll go walking, baby, arm in arm. Like that couple on the corner do, 'cause girl, I will always be in love with you. And when I look in your eyes, I'll still see that spark. For the shadows fall until the room grows dark. And when I leave this earth, true companion, oh, a true companion, true companion, true
travel on to where the two shall be as one. Gathered here to unite Roger and Denise in marriage. However, there's no man on earth that has the power to unite. The true uniting takes place in the heart and mind of each, at that very special point in time when they know they're happier together than they are apart. And not only are they happier together, but they choose to make this commitment to one another and then share this with their loved ones. And so the commitment has already taken place. The uniting has already taken place in the eyes of God. What we're doing here is reaffirming that now through this ceremony. This gives us an opportunity to bask in the light of their love. And believe me, in the time that I have spent with them, I've really had a chance to get in touch with the quality of and the depth of the love that is between them. And there's no doubt in my mind what a magnificent love it is. So now we are basking, we're celebrating, and we're enjoying their choice to not only to experience this ceremony, but that they invited us to come along. You know, and that is a great joy and a great privilege as far as I'm concerned. So the true uniting takes place when two people determine they are happier together than they are apart. There are no ties on earth so sweet and none so tender as those they are about to assume. There are no vows so solemn as those that they are about to make. And there is no institution on earth so sacred as that of the home that they will form. For the true home is not alone the place where they live, but it's also the dwelling place where each lives in the heart and the mind of the other. And so, Roger and Denise, true marriage is the holiest of all earthly unions. It is to be entered into reverently and with full understanding of its significance. It is a joy, it is a challenge. And if you don't know it already, each of you are about to marry an imperfect person. All of us who have gone through this at least once are already aware of that, you see. We don't look for perfection, we look for process, we look for growth, and we look for the development of a relationship that only comes through this kind of commitment. And so to be complete, marriage must be a spiritual as well as an earthly estate. And by spiritual, I do not mean religious. A spiritual relationship, as far as I can see, is the ability to move through the stuff, the ability to rise above the differences, the pettiness that often will show up in all relationships. The spiritual bond means that you transcend that, that at some point, in whatever conflict there may be, that you remember what brought you here together. That spiritual bond never goes away, but it does occasionally have to be called back up when we have a challenge in our life. So the state of matrimony is true marriage when it is based upon a deep inner spiritual communion of two souls who find completion each in the other. And now, who presents Denise to be married to Roger?
Her brothers.
I love you, not only for what you are, but for what I am when I'm with you. I love you not only for what you have made of yourself, but what you are making of me. I love you for the part of me that you bring out. I love you for putting your hand into my whipped up heart and passing over all the foolish, weak things that you can't help, dimly see there. And for drawing out into the light all the beautiful belongings that no one else had looked quite far enough to find. Okay? I love you because you are helping me to make of the lumber of my life not a tavern, but a temple. out of words of my everyday, not a reproach, but a song.
My love, I waited so long for you that I had begun to believe there was no such thing as true love, that my life would be lived out alone, that nothing precious would come in the form of someone to love. Finally, after I had given up all hope, I found you again like a miracle, like a single elegant star in the darkest of nights. Now I believe I've loved you all of my life, and I thank God for guiding me right as I found you again. No more dark and endless nights, now I have your light to guide me. All of my dreams came true. Being in love is so easy with you. And I am finally home since I found you again. Mon amour, je t'aimerai pour toujours.
Merci beaucoup.
And now, with the help of your songwriting partner and my songwriting partner, I'd like to present you with your wedding present.
Ah. Mm.
Thank you so much.
Is everybody here? Yeah.
Take you, Denise.
I, Roger, take you, Denise.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To grow and experience together.
To grow and to experience together.
The challenges and ecstasy of life.
The challenge and the ecstasy of life.
To make it as meaningful as I can.
To make it as meaningful as I can.
For you.
For you.
And for myself.
And for myself.
For those of you that don't have the advantage of being close enough, he meant every word. And now, Denise, repeat after me as you look into the eyes of your groom. I, Denise, take you, Roger.
I, Denise, take you, Roger.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To grow and experience together.
To grow and experience together.
The challenges and ecstasy of life.
The challenges and ecstasy of life.
To make it as meaningful as I can.
To make it as meaningful as I can.
For you.
For you.
And for myself.
And for myself.
And now, what tokens do you give in your marriage? These rings are a symbol of the eternal nature of God, the spiritual life unending, the unbroken unity of true marriage. The ring was never meant to symbolize bondage, but freedom, because these are circles, and what you are doing is widening your circle of love. You're bringing in now to the sphere of your love experience each other's friends, each other's family. And so this union right now represents an even greater capacity for you to experience even more love. Face the ring, okay?
That's right.
And as you remain holding your hand,
okay.
Repeat after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Pledging thee, my enduring love.
My enduring love.
Repeat after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Giving thee, my enduring love.
My enduring love.
Face each other, please. Pick one in your hand. Okay, right hand. Take that in your hand. And face each other. The bride and groom have requested the ceremony of the rose after I explained to them the significance of it. It even has a little deeper significance at this point, inasmuch as these roses, I think they're going to want to press because they come from the very grounds where the ceremony is taking place. And that all, it's sort of a serendipitous event because they did not come from the forest. At least we couldn't find them. And so the lovely lady who was in charge was so gracious to find some roses. So here we are with the roses, and it worked out just fine. You know, the roses, as long down through the ages, has been a symbol of pure love. And it is appropriate at this time that we consider the message that this beautiful flower gives to the world. These particular roses have the blend of the coloration of all of the different aspects of our personality, the purity of love, the richness of love, the love of the physical love as in the pinks and the reds that are represented. The rose blooms because of an inner beauty that must express. It does not need the affirmation or love of others in order to be beautiful. This beauty that the rose has comes from God. It's an inner design that is given as our gift. Each of you have this inner beauty given to you by God. Do not always, however, look for confirmation of that through the words or the deeds of your mate, but commit yourself to always finding a deeper level of your own inner beauty. Because if you do this, it means, and there's an inexhaustible supply of that because it's infinite, and if you keep going deeper, and releasing more and more of your own inner beauty, and you share that with you on a daily basis, there will never be stagnation. There will never be predictability. There will never be sameness. There will always be freshness and newness as this beauty now is shared with one another. And so I ask you now to exchange these roses. And let this act be the symbol of this giving, of this unqualified love and inner beauty that is within. And I advise you, on the date of your anniversary, from this time hence, remind each other of this lesson of the roses. Find time to be alone together. And then, once again, exchange roses in memory of this moment that is so rich and so full of beauty. Now will you join me in prayer? Eternal God, we give thanks that we have at least some indication of your love as we encounter it at the human level, and especially as we encounter it with Roger and with Denise. We know that each of them are richly blessed, that there has been a divine guidance that brought them together, and this guidance is with them now and with them forevermore. May they live together in the consciousness of peace, according to the spiritual realities and identities that they behold within themselves and one another. May they rejoice in perfect love, celebrating their mutual interests, celebrating all that they love to do and all that they love to create, knowing that they will always live in accordance with thy perfect will, knowing that that will is always love. Amen. You were born together, in the words of Khalil Gibran, you were born together, and together you shall be forevermore. You shall be together when the white wings of death scatter your days. Aye, you shall be together even in the silent memory of God. But let there be spaces in your togetherness. Let the winds of the heavens dance between you. Love one another, but make not a bond of love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. And give one another of your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. And sing and dance together, and be joyous. But let each one of you be alone, even as the strings of a lute are alone, though they quiver with the same music. And give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping, for only the hand of life can contain your hearts. And stand together, yet not too near together, for the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress grow not in each other's shadow.
Beautiful symbol of Christ and the Church is the marriage of husband and wife, a spiritual union that is born of a promise to love one another for life. For those who make faith the foundation of marriage, build something so strong and secure, a wonderful life filled with spiritual blessings and love that will always endure. May God Almighty bless your marriage, and may this union bring you into eternity together. God bless you.
Well, for as much as Roger and Denise have consented together in marriage, and in the presence of these witnesses have given and pledged their love and declared the same by giving and receiving a ring, I am happy to pronounce that they are husband and wife in love, in interest, and destiny. The Lord will bless you and keep you. The Lord will make his face to shine upon you. The Lord will lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace and everlasting joy forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
May embrace. Friends, George, it's my good pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Roger LaRoche.
Gather around y'all and check.
Yeah.
Take a couple quick ones. So what should we guys spend on?
How about you guys in that first step and then the kids down in front of you? And if you slide in front of you,
kids down here, everybody's around.
It's hot.
Yeah.
Did a great job in front.
Keep doing a good job.
Oops, sorry.
Sorry.
Hey, Miriam.
I've heard like four of us film, man.
Right now, it's looking good. Everybody, the cue is on the kids, all right?
Brenda,
I want to be able to see between her heads.
There you go.
Oh, Uncle,
is everybody looking pretty?
I like the pretty looking folks.
There we go. There's one. Here's another one. It's
that's pretty close. See if we can get one of those.
No.
All right. Hello, kid.
We got a room.
Okay, smile.
For Sammy, you crazy chicken.
For the movie, guys.
Where's the other one?
He's at the bar.
Don't lose that baby yet. I'm reloading.
Okay, Aaron, go over by Denise.
Aaron, here. Look at that. Let me get a few of those.
Thanks, cover.
Hey, Ramon.
I'm always a two-hand.
All right.
Jeff, we gotta see a smile out of you, dude.
Alright, here we go, everybody. There we go. That's good.
Okay, turn this way, he said.
There you go. There you go.
There you go. No.
Oh, all the way.
Right there. Yeah, right, baby.
There we go, guys.
There we go.
Good.
Very cool.
All right. Okay,
one more here.
Something to laugh about. Do you ever believe you can get rid of Roger? He's going to be here forever. We're going home.
All right, I think we're set on my
side. If anyone hits you or anything, I can attack you. I can defend you. And then if you want to sell this place, you can go through.
Yeah, I was going to talk to Gita and Betty.
Let's put a sign out for you.
Okay.
Yes.
There. We want to buy it, actually. The bride and groom.
Votre place, c'est vraiment dans le milieu. C'est vraiment là.
Sing each other's praises and have so much love for each other that it's just a wonderful thing to behold and be part of. And so I'd like to propose a toast to that. And I'd like to play a song that I wrote especially for them to celebrate this wonderful love they have for each other. When your best friend meets the person